As we reported earlier, China is still struggling with a surging coronavirus outbreak, one that's spread in small numbers to at least 25 other territories or countries. William Brangham gets an update now on where things stand today.
The official death toll from this coronavirus has more than doubled in the last week. The official number of confirmed cases has also more than doubled. Chinese officials have said for several days that they believe that the number of new cases may be slowing. But how accurate are these official numbers? Without knowing that, we can't really know how bad this outbreak is or how bad it might get. Joining me now is Lawrence Gostin. He's a professor of global health law, and he directs the World Health Organization's Collaborating Center at Georgetown University. Welcome.
Thanks for having me.
Help us understand. We know that there's this surging number of cases. Where do you see this going?
Well, I mean, I think we have to be prepared for the, you know, reasonable possibility or even likelihood that we won't contain this in the foreseeable future. I mean, you've got more than a billion people in China with a readily transmissible infection. If it spreads in that congested population and then eventually the travel bans are lifted, one can just foresee that it could escalate.
Escalate meaning this could turn into a true global pandemic.
It could. You know, the touchstone is twofold. I mean, one, can we slow it on mainland China? But two, are there going to be mini epidemics in other parts of the world? That's what happened with SARS. And right now we've got so-called human-to-human community transmission that has nothing to do with travel from China, you know, in places like France, the UK, and Hong Kong. So we need to watch that carefully. If it balloons into an epidemic in those places, we could be having a pandemic quite easily.
What is it that most concerns you when you look at this and you look at what is being done in China, what is being done elsewhere? What's most troubling to you?
I mean, first of all, I mean, I think looking back, it's very, very clear that there was a lot of transmission going on in China before they actually reported it. And, you know, some 5 million people left Wuhan, which is the hot zone of contagion in the country. So that was the first thing. But the other problem is that they haven't accepted cooperation and help in a very fulsome way.
You mean from the WHO?
From the WHO, the US CDC, and others who are really experienced in terms of fighting an epidemic. And that's, you know, a problem. It's many weeks into the epidemic now, and if you look at when it really started, more than a month, and only today an exploratory team from WHO landed in Beijing. It's not going to Wuhan or Hubei province where it's happening. And so we don't know their rules of engagement. Are they going to be able to have independent verification of the data? Will they have access to patients? Will they have genomic sequencing data from various parts of China? Or will China be inscrutable? I mean, it's a country that really prizes itself on its sovereignty, being in control, and it doesn't really want independent people there saying, no, that's not exactly what's happening. Something else is happening.
We also don't really know the true mortality rate of this virus, right? We know the official number of deaths,
yeah.
We know the official number of cases, but without those being truly accurate, we can't really know.
We don't know. I mean, my feeling is, and my gut is that the case numbers are way underestimated, that there are many, many more cases. But the death rate is probably about right because there are so many people that we don't know that have the virus, and we're not seeing a whole lot of deaths. But that doesn't mean we shouldn't take it really seriously. You know, flu has approximately the same death rate as the coronavirus. But imagine if we had the same number of cases in the world every year with the coronavirus.
Huge death toll.
We'd see a huge death toll, and we don't want circulating novel viruses in addition to the flu. Absolutely, we need to try to get this under control.
For American viewers who might be watching this news and being nervous, maybe potentially terrified, what would you say to them?
I would say to them, you know, take it seriously, but just remain calm. The risk to the American public is very, very low. The US CDC is beyond doubt the best in the world. If it were to happen here, in any number of, if you had escalating cases, I have very high confidence that, CDC would be able to, you know, isolate cases, quarantine those who were, actually exposed, and bring it under containment very, very rapidly.
Lawrence Gostin of Georgetown, thank you so much.
Thanks, appreciate it.